In this video, I'd like to show an example of second-order non-homogeneous differential equation. Before looking at the example, you need to know the solution formula for second-order differential equations. Ay double prime plus by prime plus cy equal f of x as shown. Notice that there are two parts, y sub c and y sub p in the complete solution. One part, y sub c, is solving a homogeneous differential equation. Y sub c is often called a complementary solution. When we solve a homogeneous equation part, we need to choose the adequate solution type from the table shown, depending on the roots of auxiliary equation. Notice that the auxiliary equation is an algebraic equation which is obtained from the differential equation by replacing y squared by m squared, y prime by m, and y by 1. The second part is finding the particular solution y sub p. Let's take a look at the example. Solving the differential equation y double prime minus 2y prime plus y equal x plus e to the x. Since the complete solution to the equation has two parts, y sub c and y sub p, let's start with the first part, y sub c. First, we need to create a homogeneous differential equation from the original equation. Since this must be homogeneous, we just make the left side of the equation be zero. Next, make the auxiliary equation from the homogeneous differential equation am squared plus bm plus c equals zero by replacing y double prime by m squared, y prime by m, and y by 1. Since a is the coefficient of y double prime, b is the coefficient of y prime, and c is the coefficient of y, a equal 1, b equal negative 2, and c equal 1 in this case. So the auxiliary equation should be m squared minus 2m plus 1 equals 0. Let's solve the above auxiliary equation by factoring method if possible. If not, we need to use the quadratic formula. We can factor it by completing the square formula as m minus 1 to the square equals 0. Therefore, the root is m equal 1. Since we found the root of m equal 1 for the auxiliary equation, now we need to select which type of the solution for y sub c. As you can see the table, there are three types of solutions. Our root, m equal 1, is a double root, so we select the second type. Since m equal 1, we're substituting 1 into the solution to get y sub c equal c sub 1 e to the x plus c sub 2 x e to the x. C sub 1 and c sub 2 are some constant. So we found the solution for y sub c part. Let's go back to the previous slide. Now that we found the solution for the homogeneous part, let's move on to the second part, the particular solution. For the particular solution y sub p part, we make use of f of x in the original equation, since y sub p must be similar to f of x. If you take a closer look at f of x, it has x, a constant, which is the derivative of x, and e to the x terms. We need to include all possible derivatives of f of x as well when setting up y sub p. If we take the derivative of e to the x, we still have the same form as e to the x. Using undetermined coefficients a, b, and c to make proposed y sub p as a plus bx plus c e to the x. A is some constant, bx is the x term, and the last one e to the x term with unknown coefficient c. At this point, we need to check if there are some duplicate terms with y sub c, which already we found. If compare them, we can see the duplicate term e to the x. In order to avoid the duplicate terms, multiply the smallest integral x to get cx e to the x as a new term. However, we can see another duplicate term x e to the x in y sub c. So we need to multiply another x again. Therefore, the correct modified y sub p should be a plus bx plus cx squared e to the x. We are still working on finding y sub p part, as we have not found the undetermined a, b, and c values. If we look at the equation, we can see y double prime, y prime, as well as y. So we need to find the first and the second derivatives of y sub p then. To find the derivative y sub p, we apply the product rule as well as two derivative formulas. Applying the product rule for the last term to get b plus 2c x e to the x plus cx squared e to the x as the first derivative. Again, applying the product rule for the second and third terms of the first derivatives to get 2c e to the x plus 2cx e to the x plus 2cx e to the x plus cx squared e to the x. Simplifying it to get 2c e to the x plus 4cx e to the x plus cx squared e to the x. Now we have the first and the second derivatives of y sub p. Since our y sub p must satisfy the original equation, we substitute yp, y prime p, and y double prime p into the original equation to find the particular values of a, b, and c. First, we substitute 2c e to the x plus 4cx e to the x plus cx squared e to the x for y double prime. Next, we substitute b plus 2cx e to the x plus cx squared e to the x for y prime. Keep minus 2 in front of y prime. Lastly, we substitute a plus bx plus cx squared e to the x for y. And of course, do not forget to make them equal to f of x, x plus e to the x. Simplify the left side of the equation. Collecting like terms to get 2c e to the x minus 2b plus a plus bx equal x plus e to the x. Rearranging by terms to get the left side of the equation as 2c e to the x plus bx plus bracket a minus 2b equal x plus e to the x. We are still looking for the y sub p solution. Now, equating the coefficient of each term on both sides of the equation to solve for a, b, and c values. First, for the x term, left side of the equation has bx, and the right side of the equation has 1x. Bx must be equal to 1x, so b must be 1. Next, for e to the x term, left side of the equation has 2c e to the x, and the right side of the equation has 1 e to the x. So 2c must be 1 to be equal, which gives c equal 1/2. For the constant term, left side of the equation has a minus 2b, and the right side of the equation has 0. So a minus 2b must be 0 to be equal. That is, a equal to b. Since we already have the value of b, substituting b equal 1 to get a equal 2. Now that we have a, b, and c values, let's substitute them into our modified y sub p equation. Finally, we found the particular solution as y sub p equaled 2 plus x plus half x squared e to the x. Let's check the particular solution y sub p just in case. Let's find out the first and the second derivatives of y sub p. Applying the product rule for the last term to get 1 plus x e to the x plus 1 half x squared e to the x as the first derivative. Applying the product rule for the second and third terms of the first derivative to get e to the x, x e to the x plus x e to the x plus 1 half x squared e to the x as the second derivative. Simplifying it to get e to the x, 2x e to the x plus 1 half x squared e to the x. Substituting each into the left side of the original equation and simplifying the terms to get x plus e to the x, which is exactly the right side of the original equation, which means that our particular solution is correct. Let's go back to the previous slide. Now that we have checked the particular solution, let's write the complete solution. We just put the two solutions together to get the complete solution as y equals c sub 1 e to the x plus c sub 2 x e to the x plus 2 plus x plus 1 half x squared e to the x. Thank you for watching. See you next time.